A verse that inshallah we will close with a little bit later on when inshallah we reach the hour by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about Yahya. When he speaks about these people, he mentions the names of the prophets Zakariya wa Yahya, and then he speaks, he says,
إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ وَيَدْعُونَنَا رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا وَكَانُوا لَنَا خَاشِعِينَ.
They used to make haste towards goodness. Anything good, they used to rush towards it. Any act of worship, something to please Allah, they used to rush towards it. And they used to call out to us, having hope in our mercy and fearing our punishment as well. And they were from amongst the humble, those who were dedicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the pious. They were always concentrating in acts of worship. And they had fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One day, the king of the time, and his name is not mentioned, but he heard that there is this man, and he knew him quite well as well, Yahya, but now he had heard that people love him more than you. You are a king, you are the ruler. People dislike you, but there is one man, people are flocking to him in their thousands, and they love him. They want to listen to him every time, moment of the day and night. Who is he? His name is Yahya. The king became jealous. Who is this man? We need to see what he's doing. So on. But in the interim, something else had happened. Allah decided something else would happen. This king fell in love with his own niece. That means his own brother's daughter. And he wanted to marry her. And Yahya was a messenger who used to get up and lecture regularly. And he used to remind people of what is permissible and what is prohibited without fearing. So he constantly said to people that it is forbidden to do this, it is forbidden to do that. And people used to take heed and they used to listen to him because of the way he spoke to them and because they knew that this man loves us so passionately. He really wants to see that we are saved from the fire of Jahannam. So he said in one of his lectures that it is forbidden to marry a niece. And whoever does that, he will be cursed by the Almighty. And it is a great sin, abomination, work of the devil, and so on. And the king got to hear this. He became very, very angry. Why is he lecturing? Why is he speaking on a controversial topic? Why? He knows what is happening here. This is controversy. We don't want it. Imagine, to this day, you have people, when you get up and say something correct, they call it controversial because they don't want to hear what is right. That is a sign of failure. As I always say, it is the clutch of the devil. We better release it before we go too far. So Yahya, he hit the nail on the head and he says, why are these people, or the king is now saying, why is this man saying that you are not allowed to marry your niece when he knows that I want to do this? Now he couldn't do that, because had he did that, the people would have reneged against him, probably stood up against him, maybe fought him. There would have been chaos, dancing for him and singing for him at different occasions and so on, and luring him until he really felt this desire that I need this woman in my life. So she said, no, you have to marry me. Defy this man. Imagine a woman ruling the whole roost. One woman creating havoc. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, she said, no, you get rid of this man. You must marry me, number one. Number two is, as mahar, I want the head of Yahya. Look at how dirty, filthy, ugly, bad, wretched, evil this woman is. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala safeguard us. These stories are not mentioned in the Quran as fairy tales. They are there for us to apply in our own communities and in our own societies and in our own situations. Wherever they fit, we fit them to learn a lesson. And the idea is to learn a lesson for myself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us steadfastness. What had happened? The king decided, okay, that's it. He sends his army and he told his men, we need the head of this man. Yet the man was loved by everyone. They went into him whilst he was engaged in prayer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his mihrab, in that place of worship. They cut his head off and took it back to the king. The Prophet Yahya, John, may peace be upon him. He had met the Prophet Jesus and they had lived, they had discussed, inshallah, we will see that tomorrow. But We are speaking now of how he was brutally murdered. And Allah says in the Quran, and we will end with this verse.
إن الذين يكفرون بآيات الله إن الذين يكفرون بآيات الله ويقتلون النبيين بغير حق ويقتلون الذين يأمرون بالقسط من الناس فبشرهم بعذاب أليم أولئك الذين حبطت أعمالهم في الدنيا والآخرة وما لهم من ناصرين.
Those who disbelieve and they go out killing the messengers of Allah and they go out killing those who are instructing them to do good and those who are upholding the justice from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, let them know that there is a severe punishment awaiting them. Those are the ones whose deeds have been wasted in this world and in the next, and indeed in the life after death, they will have nobody to help them at all. This is a powerful verse that Allah makes mention of in Surah Ali Imran, when he's speaking of the family of Imran. That family was a very small family. And a whole chapter in the Quran is named after the family of Imran. It was made up of Imran, his wife, his daughter Mary or Maryam, and her child Jesus or Isa alayhi salam. The Quran has named a whole chapter after the family of Imran, another whole chapter after Mary herself, Maryam, may peace be upon her. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us goodness. The lesson is, when we get irritated by those who are telling us Allah has said this and Allah has said that and this is the law of Allah and this is what it is supposed to be, that is the first sign of rejection from within. We need to be careful. Let us extinguish that fire as it starts. Don't allow yourself to be irritated when people press the right buttons and when they are speaking about items we are guilty of involving in. Because that is a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like the Prophet Yahya, when he lectured them, they got upset. And they started saying controversial, and we don't want it, and he shouldn't say this. They ended up killing him. Some of us, may Allah protect us, we would like to extinguish people, we would like to remove people from the face of the earth when they tell us, brother, you are totally wrong, you are heading in the wrong direction, be warned of a punishment and so on. We don't like it. Let us change our ways and habits, inshallah. Let us love those who correct us. That is the only way we will improve. Until we meet tomorrow, inshallah. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.